your natural compassion is getting in your way. When Dr. King, he was thrown in jail, and Abernathy came to visit him in jail and had to walk through a gauntlet of parents screaming at him about, my kids are in jail. What are you going to do about it? He goes to King and he says, these parents are freaking out. Dr. King said, I don't care about that. I've written something and I want you to take it. And I need you to bring me more paper that became the basis of the civil rights movement. Now imagine if he had said, oh, okay, yeah, let's figure out how to, you know, get the kids out of prison so the parents aren't angry, right? He had to be mission focused. And when you're mission focused, you upset a lot of people because they don't see the mission until the mission starts to happen. If you are willing to do this, it will make a lot of women angry because what they will say is you're blaming the victim. And what you come back with is the problem is you think you're a victim. It's their experience of you, not your experience. For most of us, we take on other people's experiences because we don't want to break rapport. The thing that I love about the basic Star Wars mythology of the Force is that there's the dark side and the light side. And they never talk about extinguishing the dark side. What they talk about is bringing it into balance because the dark side is the power of the Force. The light side doesn't have power. It's the integrity. That's the balance inside of each of us. Your dark side is the powerful one. Let's just fucking do this shit. The light side is like, I don't want people to think of me poorly. Remember, Martin Luther King didn't say, hey guys, I got this dream. It's my thing. I don't want to push it on you. Not nearly as powerful as saying, I have a dream with the subtext being, this should be your dream too. That's the work I want you to do in practicing being more influential. The pushback that you get, it is an opportunity to help someone see their own fear. If someone says something like, well, that's true for you, it's not true for me. And you say, I know that what I just said to you is challenging. And what I want you to do is to take this on as the truth and see what happens. And always throw it away later, but take it on as the truth now. You know, when I was studying personal development, I said to my teacher, I want to be a great instructor. And he said, don't be a great instructor. Be an effective instructor. Whether they leave the course and say, wow, Dan Gordon, he was amazing. Or they leave the course going, God, what an asshole. I can't believe he said this and this. There's still an effect that I had on someone where things are moving. Either way, it's now churning inside of them. That's the game that we're playing.